Good afternoon, South Africa. Welcome to Afternoon Express. I'm Bonnie Bully. We're halfway through the month, and if you still feel like you're not quite spring ready, we've got all kinds of ideas to help you. We also put you onto a new craze called face profiling with expert Beatrix Picard-Cambridge, where she can tell the truth about you just by looking at your face. Does it sound like magic? Yes, it is. Speaking of magic, Clem's here in the kitchen to make more magic.
Yeah.
And we're making beef koftas.
So the kind of things like a kebab, but like on a little stick. But it's just the meat, the minced meat itself. Little extra bits added to it. So, you know what I mean? The chunks of meat, the vegetables. That's not
I call you the mince whisperer. Because you can do all kinds of magical things.
I love mince.
With mince. Yeah.
I love mince. Yeah. I mean, as long as you have mince in the house, you have a meal.
Awesome. And the keyword for this recipe is beef. So SMS the keyword beef to 33650 for the full recipe and the list of ingredients. The SMSs cost R1.50. No free SMSs apply. Okay, so should we get started?
So I'm using beef mince today. Normally you would use, get this goat's mince or sheep's mince. I'm not scared of goat's mince. I'd be like every day.
I love goats. They're so cute.
They're cute.
Yeah, I think.
So the beef mince goes into a bowl.
As long as you can eat them.
I don't know. I mean, in Jamaica, that's a thing. So, I mean, we should try it.
Well, also in rural South Africa, that's a thing.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what? We should do a goat mince episode.
A goat day.
So our beef mince goes into the bowl, seasoning. It's just salt and pepper. Mm-hmm. Then I'm using something quite exotic again. I'm using some za'atar.
Za'atar. I know about za'atar.
So, educate the people.
Well, you can mix za'atar with sour cream. Right?
Yes. But the spice
actually
goes
well with shawarmas, and it goes well as a dip, right?
That's so amazing.
And
it's true.
Available at Woolworths.
It is.
Yes.
So the za'atar we're using, like I said, it's got sesame seeds in it. It's got sumac in it, and some oregano, some other ground spices. But you get like quite a nice perfumed, fragrant flavor from it.
Awesome.
So again, that's going to contribute so well to our koftas. I love it. I mean, I'm generous.
And
with
it goes well with cheese as well, doesn't it?
Well,
cream cheese.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
Okay.
Cool, awesome. So that's in there. I'm going to add a little bit of heat, some cayenne pepper.
Okay.
I know you're not...
Me some red spice, anything
cool.
British.
There you go. That's
enough. A little bit of.
So that's in there, and I've got some caramelized onions that I caramelized a little earlier.
All right.
And that's going to add a little sweetness to our koftas as well.
Okay.
A little bit of moisture as well.
Right.
So what I got to do now is we use my spoon, bring it all together.
Okay.
You can totally, at this stage, start using your hands, which I'm about to do real soon.
Yeah.
Just abandon the spoon.
I love that feeling of that squeezing that mince in my hands.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay, so I should have asked you to do that.
Yeah, I
should. Then you just take your skewer. You can actually, you know what I'm going to do? Here's a bit of a tip. Instead of doing one, take two skewers. That way you get more support when you actually do this.
Oh, okay.
So get them in there.
I told you you were the mince whisperer.
I love mince.
I mean, look at you, like a double skewer kofta.
Now, there's actually a skill.
Only on Afternoon Express.
Excuse me?
Only on Afternoon Express.
Yeah. Only.
Okay.
So you get it nice, beautifully shaped, compacted nicely.
Okay.
And then on a really hot griddle pan, just place that down. And what you can do is, well, again, I always say, once it hits the griddle, leave it. That's
walk
very
away.
Important here as well. Because if you turn it before it's really got that crust in it, it's going to fall apart.
It's going to fall apart.
So ensure that it sits there, cooks perfectly, kind of seals, and sets a bit before you start turning it over. So I'm going to stop sides with you again. Give my hands a bit of a clean over here. To go with this kofta, I'm going to make something quite fragrant again, and a bit light to lift that smoky, beefy flavor. So we're going to go with a bit of like a parsley and a mint relish. What do you think?
I like the sound of that.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah.
So real simple.
Very refreshing.
It is. Like I said, it goes really well with that smoky flavor on the beef. So I'm keeping it quite rustic. I'm going stems and leaves. So often we just abandon the stems, which is not cool. There's quite a lot of flavor in there. So don't chuck it away.
Well, there's that whole movement towards imperfect vegetables as well, isn't it?
It is. And using 100% of your vegetables, even the greens of the carrot, can be eaten, which is quite new.
Yeah.
Well, maybe it's quite old. I mean, who stopped eating it? And a bit of mint. Again, that mint's going to add amazing freshness.
Okay.
I love mint. Like, growing up as a kid, I never used to like mint. But now, as an adult, I love it.
How do you know about mint growing up as a kid?
I don't like mint.
You clearly, like, were groomed to become a chef. When did you first start eating mint?
It's a long story.
That's a long
story. Can I have half an hour?
I have a lot of time.
So extra mint, again, that's just going to add so much freshness to this.
Okay.
That goes in there.
All right.
And a little, actually, I'm going to do everything on the board.
Nice. Okay.
Yeah. So, some green olives.
Green olives chopped up. Okay.
Chopped up already. A little bit of lemon zest.
Okay.
A little bit of garlic.
Right.
And a little bit of extra salt and pepper. Mm-hmm. And we're keeping it rustic. So rustic. No, no bowls. On the board. On the board. And then all I'm going to do then, a little drizzle of olive oil.
Love it. Okay.
Cool. So that's done. So what I've got is some pita breads. That's going to go down. A little bit of yogurt. And I'm using a plain yogurt.
Nice. Yeah. Refreshing.
It is.
This is a great spring summer recipe.
It absolutely is. Koftas go down. A little bit of yogurt just over the top.
All right.
And then finally, we can top it with a little bit of this relish that we've made. Just mix it all together and just sprinkle that over.
Nice.
What do you think?
That looks lovely. Is this ready to be turned over?
It is.
I'm a bit worried about this.
So let's swap sides. I'll do that for you.
Okay. You do it.
Look at that.
It looks beautiful. Awesome. Looks absolutely gorgeous.
So, to finish up the dish, a little squeeze of lemon. You know we love lemon on everything.
Always.
So a beautiful squeeze of lemon.
Okay.
And that's done.
That's it. Quick and easy.
Done.
Yeah. Okay. Just a reminder, the keyword is beef. SMS the keyword to 33650 and there you'll get the full recipe and the ingredients. SMSs cost R1.50. No free SMSs apply. If you didn't get any of that, here's a quick recap. There you have it. Now you know how to make this delicious beef kofta. Looks absolutely amazing.
Thank
I can't wait to bite into it. Have you heard of something called face profiling?
No, I haven't. It sounds pretty interesting.
It does. The other day I met up with a face profiler who did a face profiling on me, and she told me a whole bunch of things about me that were absolutely accurate just by looking at my face.
Sounds a bit scary, though.
Yeah,
secrets,
yeah.
Secrets.
Yeah, it was a bit vulnerable. But you'll get to hear all about it when we return. Don't go away. Welcome back to Afternoon Express. You know the saying, a picture can say 1,000 words? Well, apparently, so can a face. I recently met up with professional face profiler Beatrix Picard-Cambridge, and I have to admit, it was a very interesting experience. Take a look. Beatrix, I'm very honored to be meeting you for a face profiling session. I mean, I've never actually met a face profiler. What does a face profiler do?
So we look at facial features, we look at symmetry, we look at lines and structure. And that tells us something about your dynamic, which we link to personality and personality traits. What happens on our faces is as a result of our perspective on our lives. So it's not necessarily an ultimate truth, it is our truth, how we perceive things. So I think we'll start with your eyebrows, which is all about handling data. Now yours have quite a lot of hair distribution, which means that you're comfortable dealing with a lot of data at any given time. And your brows have a beautiful curve to it, so the kind of data that you would be interested in would be that about people. You know, how are people, their emotions, what's up with them? And it will affect how you make your decisions. So I'm going to jump to your chin, which has a beautiful curve to it. It's rounded. And that means that you make your decisions based on what is best for the people in your life. So from there, let's go to your cheekbones, which is about power style. It feeds into this because you have high and wide cheekbones, which we call generally healer cheekbones. The kind of person who uplifts, who motivates, is always available. And in terms of your nose and work style, you have a general need to be of service to humanity. That has to be part of whatever job you do. Otherwise, you won't be happy.
Wow, that's amazing.
And adding your ears to that, you have the kind of ears that says people love telling you things. I'm looking at the nose grooves on your nose, the little areas that are more defined. It tells me that your success has come at a price, that you've had to really work at it, that there are things that you sacrificed as a result of it. I want to move upwards to your eyes and look at the slight bagginess under your eyes. Unprocessed grief, which stays a process for people, especially when we've gone through trauma or hardships. I find that it's cyclical because our bodies remember emotions. There are times that we are better and there are times that something comes to the fore again. I think the process of healing grief and pain is exactly that, it's a spiral. I can see that you have a need for intimacy, bonding. We see that in the amount of space that you have on your upper eyelid. And you like personal connection, you know, you like deep, valuable relationships. And catching this photo here from about 5 years ago, and the space is less, which means that whatever happened in this period in your life made you more isolated. You didn't want to let people in that much. Would you mind turning your head? I just want to see you in profile. So nose is all about work style, and I see a straight nose. So that's about strategic planning, long-term goals. Then I connect it with the way your forehead starts straight upwards, makes a slant and then a curve. What that means is, in your strategic planning, you will start with the steps and you would go with step 1, 2, 3, and then you don't need the steps and you know where you want to go and you're visual about it and you bring the creative edge to it and it takes on a life of its own. I mean, how amazing is that?
That is very accurate.
So I notice that you fill in your brows and I need to ask, naturally, towards the ends, do they have less hair distribution?
Well, near the ends, they start to taper and they are more sparse.
Naturally, you have what we would call starter brows or beginner brows. It means in your creative process and in the way you handle data, you are inspired. You can grab all the information. But once you're near the end of a project, when you don't feel you're good enough at it, you want to drop it.
Often when I do something for the first time or I'm trying it out for the first time, I have a need to be good at it, or good according to my perception, or the best at it. And if I feel like I'm not the best at it, I usually quit it.
That is your challenge and a growth edge, because some things will be important enough to finish. And that's where you need to learn to prioritize. But now I see a bit of a contradiction, because your power style wants to do everything yourself.
I'm also a very self-motivated person and I take accountability very seriously. But on the other end of that, I over-account, even for other people dropping the ball or things going wrong, and I struggle to blame other people for things and I usually take on all the blame.
So what would help you is to make a conscious choice about the things that's really important to succeed at and let the rest go. You know, take the pressure off yourself. And being vulnerable has a beautiful quality to it. You know, in fact, there's so much strength in vulnerability because it means we can admit that we are human, that we make mistakes. We have to, otherwise we can't be successful.
Wow, now you know some real intimate details about me. Thank you so much for joining us today, Beatrix. Lovely to see you again.
Thank you for having me.
Now, you basically use that all that information you get from a person's face profile and then you integrate it into a life coaching method.
I do. I use it corporately and privately. It is a tool that allows me entrance into someone's dynamic very, very fast, which means I can see where they are challenged, what their talents are, where best to place them in a project, how do they handle information, what data do they need. We all hear differently.
Yeah.
Some of us hear emotional aspects with greater ease than detailed data, scientific background, etc. So your face tells me what you need to hear.
Yeah.
And then I speak according to that.
Now, how do we
use this information to empower ourselves. Like all this information you gave me, I mean, I'm still like just reeling from it. I couldn't believe somebody could read me that well because it makes you feel so naked and so vulnerable.
It is, and I think it gets you to that place where you understand that vulnerability isn't weakness,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So if we take the features, each feature would have a talent and a challenge connected to it, and nothing is right or wrong. We don't see it in terms of positive or negative or good or bad. It's about what you choose to do with it. Because one part of the dynamic might be very good in a certain area in your life. If you use it in all areas, it will have downsides. I mean, for instance, if you have a need to control information, then that is very necessary in your work. But at home, you need to learn to switch that part off because you cannot control all the information regarding children, husbands, lives, family, friends. You want to change your dynamic. And what we see on a face allows us to not be cast in stone.
How is a technique like face profiling different from, say, body language?
All right, body language we can fake depending on how we feel. And it's dependent on exactly that, how we feel. Where face profiling, the features of the face don't shift during the day. The only areas that change around the face on a daily, moment-by-moment basis is around the eyes. When I look at your cheeks, for instance, they tell me about your power style. That isn't going to change depending on how you feel. It's quite set. I can gauge your dynamic accordingly, which means if I have to make decisions regarding which areas I want to place you in, for instance, in a job.
Right.
I'm going to know what would work, what would not work, what the potential problems could be with that, mm-hmm. and how do we support it. It's always about how do we support what we have and what do we do with it.
Wow. This is definitely so interesting. Thank you so much for joining us, Beatrix.
Thank you.
Who would have thought that we could learn so much about ourselves by simply looking at our faces? And to keep our faces looking their best, after the break, we get the ultimate detox beauty guide on how to get our skin ready for summer. Don't go away. Welcome back to Afternoon Express. It's the season for new beginnings and rejuvenation. Today, we'll share some expert advice on how you can detox your beauty routine, get your skin looking at its best, and what the latest skincare trends are. In the loft with us is beauty expert and blogger Candice-Lee Kannemeyer, and she's going to chat to us about where we should begin. Welcome to the loft.
Thanks, Bonnie. It's wonderful to be here.
Yeah, lovely
Thank
to
you.
Have you with us.
Thank
it's
you.
Summer, and in summer, everybody loves to show more skin.
That's
How do
right.
we prepare our skins for the sunshine?
Well, I think the most important thing is to give your body a really good exfoliation with a body scrub. You can make your own using natural sea salt or sugar. Mix a little bit of olive oil with that and a few drops of essential oil, and then just scrub it onto your skin. What exfoliation does is it removes the dead a layer of skin cells on the top of the skin. So it just makes our skin feel softer and smoother. And also, this is a very important step if you're going to be using a self-tanner because it just, that will ensure that there are no sort of funny streaks or a horrible orange kind of color. And then, of course, you know, also summer is sandal season. So I think it's important to get our feet looking good for summer. Also, because our feet are exposed to the elements in summer, often, you know, we suffer with things like dry heels, and this can be combated very easily just by applying a really good nourishing foot cream on the feet every single night, and it definitely, like I said, it will eliminate any dry and cracked heels.
And what key elements can we change in our beauty routine to make sure that our skins are smoother and glowing a bit better?
Well, I think first and foremost is to go through your makeup and sort of do a huge kind of throw out. So anything
I can't throw makeup away.
But this is the problem. You see, women love to hold onto makeup, and the problem is makeup does expire. So you've got to look at those expiry dates. If foundation starts separating or splitting, you need to throw it away. Anything that smells like a little bit funky must go what happens is mascara is another one. I mean, mascara that is dry, you don't want to use on your lashes. The problem with using products that have passed their sell-by date is that not only do they not work properly on the skin, but they can also cause things like irritation, So
infections.
So, yeah, infections. So yeah. So it's a good idea just to do a good throw out every now and then.
How important is exfoliation and how often should we do it?
Well,
because I tend to over exfoliate just because I love how it smells and it always so nice.
And you know, you want to avoid over exfoliating, especially on your face. Mm-hmm. So I would say anywhere from once to three times a week. And obviously, you know, you want to use something gentle. I always tell my readers to look for exfoliators with fruit acids. These are called chemical exfoliants, so they don't have granules that exfoliate the skin. And also, what's nice about these kind of chemical exfoliants is that they can be used on sensitive skin, and they won't cause a reaction.
Yeah. And what three essential makeup products do we need this summer?
I would say a bronzer, just to
absolutely
add a lovely... Yes, because what it does is it adds a beautiful sun-kissed glow to the skin. I think a tinted moisturizer, obviously with an SPF. Uh-huh. And then a beautiful bright lipstick, like I said, either in an orange or a pink, just brings a bit of color to the face and just really makes you look like you've tried with your makeup when you haven't really.
Yeah.
You know, it's so quick to apply.
Yeah. Now, one thing that's really important, especially as you get older, is to keep your skin hydrated.
How important do
we do that enough this summer?
Well, I think the most important thing is, you hear this all the time, is to drink enough water. Okay. 8 glasses of water a day, because you want to hydrate from the inside, and then this will help your skin to look beautiful and plump. You can also look at things like facial spritzes, just to cool your face down, you know, on hot days. And I think also it's a good idea to swap up your moisturizer that you usually use to one with a slightly lighter texture, almost like a gel texture, because this just works better in the warmer months.
It does. Oh, thank you so much, Candice.
Thanks, Bonnie.
I'm sure you're just as excited to try some or even all of the tips Candice has just shared on getting our skin summer ready. And here's some great news to top it all off. The W Beauty range of skincare products is endorsed by Beauty Without Cruelty, so we can look after our skin without harming our beautiful environment. Shop beauty online at woolworths.co.za. Summer is almost here, but we have to get through spring first. And when I think of spring, the first thing that comes to mind is a picnic in the park or enjoying a late afternoon lunch with some good friends in the sun. And that's exactly what I got up to last week. Take a look.
As a busy mom, there's nothing like having a free afternoon to spend with friends. So I've invited a few guests over to just put our feet up and welcome spring. But before we get to that, I've got a shopping list to get through. I've been given some homework.
Being surrounded by floral kingdoms outside the city, Bonnie brought that spring country feel with these pincushions. Buying in-season fruit and veg is tastier and cheaper. You leave a far smaller carbon footprint, support local suppliers, and encourage sustainable farming.
I've got all my ingredients now, and it's of course time to pay. And for that, I'll be using my Diners Club credit card, the everyday card for everyday needs.
Diners Club South Africa gives members even more choice with the introduction of a credit card, and for new members, a minimum repayment of 3% per month. You can also use the card to obtain cash over the counter or at an ATM. Very convenient, as is the events team Tina Maritz and her husband Hannes, who Bonnie had asked to cater her spring feast.
Wow, Tina, you've absolutely transformed the ingredients I've got. I mean, look at these strawberries.
Oh, yes. That's for our starter a bit later, which is a balsamic marinated strawberry salad.
Okay, wonderful. What is on the menu?
For starters, the strawberry salad. Then for mains, we're going to have some pork, apple and sage stuffed chicken breasts. Then we'll have asparagus and orange salad with that, and some slow roasted butternut and beetroot. And then for dessert, we're going to have a plum galette.
Okay, so Tina, how can I help? Because I want to be able to say to my friends that I did lend a hand.
Oh, wonderful. We're going to put this on here, and then you can grab some of the plum slices.
Right, so that is an almond butter mixture.
Almond butter and a bit of golden caster sugar.
Wow. So now do we place the plums on top?
Plums can go on top.
And if your plums still have a bit of an early season crunch in them, what can you do to maybe soften them?
Well, usually in the beginning of season, fruit tend to be not as sweet as they would be. So you can definitely drench them with honey or just sprinkle them with a bit of icing sugar.
Absolutely.
Okay, so we're just going to tuck in the sides.
Mm-hmm.
Just like this.
that's nicely done. You can tell you've been doing this for a while.
Comes with a lot of practice.
Tina grew up in Stellenbosch in a family of eight, so catering to large parties is practically second nature to her.
Just some eggs so it bakes nicely.
Gets that nice golden colour.
That's it. You've also been doing this.
Yeah. I've learnt a few tricks in the kitchen.
So now it's ready for the oven.
Okay, wonderful. I can't wait to see what it looks like when it comes out. Mm. So how long does it go into the oven for?
50 minutes, but halfway through you cover it with foil so it just doesn't brown too much.
Okay.
Tina's husband and decor specialist, Hannes, was transforming the dining space for the occasion.
Hannes, this is looking amazing, and as you can see, I'm appropriately dressed, and it was all a coincidence.
Gorgeous. You look gorgeous.
Thank you. So what's the theme for our table setting today?
Well, we are celebrating spring today, mm-hmm. So we got the most amazing, colourful flowers and fresh produce from next to the road, from the shops, and we just decided to cover this whole table with splashes of colour.
Wow. Absolutely amazing. And I can see it's quite a rustic feel. You've got some beetroot tops over there.
Yes, yes. So the main idea is to make use of what you have in your house. So most of the time you will have beetroot and you sometimes think you can only eat it. But just having these half pieces of cut beetroot can be lovely on the table for that organic feel.
Yes.
So it gives a feel of it's growing out of the table.
Oh, I think my guests are going to be very impressed.
Oh, I hope so. I really hope so. Bonnie, I actually have something you can help me with.
Yay.
It's a very interesting method that we're using now. If you want something fresh, because we're celebrating spring, we are making use of fruit as oasis. Because most of the time, you don't just have pretty vases in your cupboard. So we're going to make use of a papaya to actually put in the flowers. The thing is, it's already fresh, it is already dense, so you can just put it in there and your flowers will last as well, as if it's standing in water.
That's amazing.
And then we're going to put in all these poppies, piece by piece, and build a kind of garden in the papaya.
So do we keep the pips in?
Yes, we do. Yes, we do, to have that organic feel to the table.
Yeah. It must be good for the flowers as well.
Yes, 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 because it's so moist already. Yeah. And the thing is, you don't have to throw away the papaya as you do the oasis.
It's amazing.
Okay, so what flowers are available this season?
Well, this is the prettiest time of the year. So we have the most amazing, amazing flowers. We have the azaleas, that is my absolute favorite at the moment. And of course, the blossoms are absolutely gorgeous. And the spin cushions, quite bold, that are growing all around now, yes. Okay, well, Bonnie, great job. I'm going to take it just like this, and we place it right in here, and we're ready.
That looks amazing. Well, my guests have started to arrive, so I'm going to go welcome them. Thank you so much.
Awesome, it's a pleasure.
The idea is to work with what you've got, like the blossoms and fresh produce so abundant at this time of year. Bonnie had invited her city friends to do what communities in the countryside do. Welcoming in the new season with feasts and festivals. Be creative and spontaneous, not overthinking or complicating anything. Rather keep it understated and focus on the main reason you have your friends over, having a ball.
Voila!
Oh my goodness, this looks beautiful.
Bonnie felt brilliant, having seized the day and made the most of her free hours. For those one-of-a-kind moments or everyday convenience, your Diners Club credit card is perfect for you. So make the best things in life easier and more rewarding.
Well, I've had an insanely wonderful time, and thank you so much to the Crack Events Coordination Team and to Diners Club for this incredible experience. I've certainly enjoyed it. Cheers, ladies.
Wow, that was so much fun hanging out with my girlfriend. Speaking of special guests, we have a special guest joining us in the loft today to cook us our next meal. Zola Nene, the resident chef of the Morning Espresso Show.
Hello.
Welcome.
Thank
you. Look like spring.
Oh, you look always like spring.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
And our kitchen looks like spring.
What it does. Making? All bright and colourful. We're talking afternoon tea, and I'm going to make one of my special treats that should always be on your afternoon tea table.
Nice. I can't wait. Don't go away when we return. Express yourself. Welcome back to Afternoon Express. We're about to start cooking something sweet and refreshing in our kitchen. And to help us do that is Espresso Morning Show resident chef Zola Nene.
Hello.
Awesome. So we're about to get started.
Yes, we're making one of my favorite treats to have not only on an afternoon tea table, but summertime, Christmas time, any time actually. I love
just
a ginger
family
biscuit.
Family time. Exactly. And warm, fuzzy feeling time.
Absolutely. And it's a sweet treat that you should never go amiss on your table.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So how are your stirring skills?
Good.
Okay, good.
Good.
Great. Okay, work that arm. Okay, so we've got
some grown-ass woman.
Some softened butter in there that we're going to cream with some muscovado sugar. With something like ginger biscuits, I always use a caramel or treacle sugar just like this.
Okay.
It adds to the color of the biscuits and also adds that crunch because you can see the granules are rather large.
They're rather large,
then
yes.
To that, I'm going to add an egg, which you're going to keep stirring in there. Mm-hmm. Some golden syrup as well for extra flavor.
Right.
Which is always good.
Yeah.
And then for dry ingredients, which I'm gonna mix together, we've got some cake flour.
Okay.
Which I'm gonna add some dried ginger to. It wouldn't be a ginger biscuits without it, right?
Without ginger.
And then some bicarbonate of soda, which is our chemical raising agent, which is gonna help our biscuits have a little bit of a...
Do we always use dry ginger for ginger biscuits and never fresh ginger?
I do. I do. Just because, you know, when you're baking, it's like a spice. It's like using a spice, like cinnamon, for example.
Right.
You could use the fresh grated ginger. It's
in
just
muffins,
you'd have
perhaps,
to
perhaps if you were
in muffins,
yeah.
Absolutely. But in these biscuits, you'd need a hell of a lot.
Wow.
Yeah. Just because the dry ginger gives, you know, so much flavor with a little bit.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so to that I'm gonna add the dry ingredients, so you keep mixing.
Okay.
And you can see it's a very easy biscuit
it
mixture.
Is. It is. I'm definitely gonna make these for Baker's Day at my son's school.
Yeah, I think they'd love them.
Yeah.
You know, ginger biscuits often people say that they're for old people, but they're not, because
yeah.
I don't consider myself that old and I quite like them. But the ginger flavor in these is very subtle, and also the filling in them is white chocolate and cream cheese. So it's really, it sort of takes it up a notch. Okay.
Okay.
So all you have to do, thank you, your arm must be tired by now.
Yeah.
So all you got to do is mix this until it all comes together into a dough.
Yeah.
Then rest it in the fridge, wrap it in cling film, rest it in the fridge. And then
and
you'll
voila.
Get, here we go, one that's rested. So I'm going to just dust some flour on the surface.
I mean, you do have a point there. I've only ever seen old people eat ginger biscuits.
Well, listen. Do you consider me old?
No.
Yeah, because we might fight.
You're younger than me.
Okay, good. Yes. So no, young people do eat ginger biscuits. So all you do after it's rested is you roll it out just like this.
Okay.
Here we go. Just bring it together if it cracks a little bit too much.
Right.
But these are very forgiving. That's why they're so great to do with kids.
Nice.
And then you can choose the thickness yourself. Obviously, the thicker you make them, the longer they're going to take to cook.
Wow.
Okay. Then I like a bit of a petal. As
yes,
a cutter. There
pretty.
We go. Or you could use, you could do hearts, you could do whatever shape that you like.
Yeah.
There we go. And then preheat your oven to 180 degrees.
Okay.
And these will bake for about 15 to 20 minutes, depending on the thickness, like I said.
I see.
And that's as easy as it is to make them. Make sure they cool before you get to the funnest part, which is filling
and
them.
And how
obviously.
Can you tell if they're done? Do they get a bit golden?
They go the golden around the edges and they get very crispy.
Okay.
Yeah?
Perfect.
Okay, so for me, for ginger biscuits, the filling is also something that makes it.
Oh,
so before
filling.
We get to my favorite part, let's do a bit of a cleanup.
Okay.
Okay.
I mean, your kitchen's definitely clean. I mean, when I'm cooking up a storm or baking, it's hell in
absolutely.
The kitchen.
Absolutely. Sorry, let me get the clock. So for me, the trick is to clean as you go, and that makes everything so much easier. And now we're ready to decorate.
Perfect.
Okay. So what I use to fill these is some cream cheese and white chocolate frosting.
What?
I know, it's very decadent, but it's
oh
a must.
Oh my goodness.
It's a must. And then these biscuits are already cooled.
Okay.
So I'm just going to grab one of these. And then all you do is just fill them as generously as you
cream
like.
Cream cheese and white chocolate.
Cream cheese,
frosting.
White chocolate, icing sugar,
mm-hmm.
and a bit of butter, because more butter, more better.
Okay.
And then just sandwich them together, just like that.
My
then
mouth
pop
is
them,
watering.
I know, they're really good. Pop them onto either a platter or... a cake stand, something like that. Then you snow them for me, because everything with snow is always better.
Oh, absolutely.
So that's just a bit of icing sugar.
Oh, nice.
And there we go. And we've made all of this, and our surface is really clean. So for me, you must always clean as you go. It makes everything that much easier. So then you're not left with a whole lot of, you know, mess at the end.
Yeah.
So look, we're ready
so
to
you're
eat.
Not chasing everyone out of the
no,
kitchen
no, no,
every
no,
time
I'm not
you're cooking.
Wait for you to start eating while I have to clean. It's all done so we can eat together.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Zola.
It's
absolutely gorgeous. If you want to stand a chance of winning a high tea for you and a friend, as well as a Mr. Muscle product hamper, then all you need to do is SMS Mr. Muscle, your name and city, to 33650. SMSs are charged at 1.50 each. T's and C's apply and can be found on afternoonexpress.co.za. Thank you so much, Zola Nene, for all those useful baking and cleaning tips in the kitchen. And no high tea is complete without the main component, tea, of course. It's time to share another moment with Five Roses. South Africa's favourite tea is expertly blended to ensure the highest quality consistently. It's a commitment to excellence that Five Roses puts into making the perfect cup of tea, which delivers its distinctively superior taste. This week, Jeannie met up with tea master Dinesh for high tea at the Marion on Nickel to discuss the aromatic and flavourful delights of the Five Roses Infusions range.
The luxurious Marion and Nickel Hotel offers a tranquil setting amidst flourishing gardens, perfect for a moment of reflection over a good cup of tea. Today I'm meeting with Tea Master Dinesh Vijayawadna to enjoy these gorgeous surroundings and to learn more about the Five Roses Infusions range. With names like Grass Tiger and Theatre of Dreams, it sounds like a delicious story in every cup. Dinesh, tell me about this exciting new range of teas.
Infusion range is brought to give you a unique taste experience with delicious flavors and real ingredients of herbs and spices and black tea, the long leaf black teas, and of course the natural flavors that we use. We've also put it in a tea bag that it's called a pyramid tea bag, and it allows these natural ingredients to swell and to infuse very nicely, and it's also visually very appealing. Herbal infusions are becoming really popular worldwide. It's almost a fashionable beverage now, mainly due to the uniqueness and the taste experience that people are finding. And also, it has the health connotations.
I noticed when we opened the tea bags, they were so deliciously fragrant. What is the range comprised of?
We can start off with the African Queen. It's real rooibos with real pieces of vanilla, which gives you a really round, smooth taste. And it actually takes milk very well.
Yeah.
Then we have what we call the Grass Tiger. So it has an eastern taste profile. It has real ginger pieces and lemongrass and flavored. So it gives you a little bit of a lift when you have it. It's a zesty tasting tea. Then we have Theater of Dreams. Now this is, you can see it's really real pieces of real chamomile with pieces of lavender.
It looks like potpourri actually.
Absolutely, but it tastes delicious as well. And that is to calm you and to soothe you and your soul when you need it. And then finally, we have New Beginnings. This is a blend of fruit pieces, hibiscus, rose hip, and even some calendula petals. It's a really fruity blend. It's red in color when it is brewed, and it has a sour sweet taste to it.
I'm so fascinated by the process by which you put these blends together. Like, I can imagine it to be one huge laboratory with all these different flowers and spices.
Something like that. So there are so many varieties of different flavors and different ingredients and herbals around. So we just let ourselves go, just let our creative side come out, and we use many of these ingredients in many blend compositions, using different spices, herbals, flavors, black teas, green teas, and we just make many, many blends, and then go through the process of choosing and eliminating the ones we don't like. And this is the range that we have come up with for you.
Hello, welcome to the Marion & Nickel.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us today. I've just prepared the following snacks for you to pair with your teas.
Mm-hmm.
I've got some light chocolate mousse filled choux puffs, followed by some carrot cake and a very light strawberry cheesecake, and then some chocolate brownie on the side there just to complement the teas.
Thank you so much. These teas are so deliciously indulgent hot, but couldn't you serve them cold as well?
Absolutely. You could have lots of fun and be very creative with what you do with these blends. You could add pieces of fruit into it, for example, the berry teas. You could add your strawberries, or with the green teas and the lemongrass, you could add pieces of apple. You could garnish it with mint, or you could even put in some honey to sweeten. You don't also need to only use water. Once you've made the tea, you can actually add lemonade if you want to sweeten it up and zest it up a bit. Or if you don't like sugar, you could add just soda water. So there are lots of things that you can do to make this really funky and exciting and unique.
Well, I definitely think we should sweeten up our tea time now.
Okay.
Here you go. Good choice. Whether you're an African queen or you simply want to slip away into a theater of dreams, the Five Roses Infusions range offers you a superior taste experience that'll take your taste buds on quite the adventure. Till next time, enjoy a cuppa made by the best.
We're giving away a fabulous Five Roses gift pack containing an assortment of their delicious teas. To win, simply SMS the keyword Five Roses, your name and city to 33650. SMSs are charged at R1.50 and T's and C's do apply. So visit our website, afternoonexpress.co.za, for details. Join us again next week, and until then, remember that nobody makes better tea than you and Five Roses. Welcome back to Afternoon Express. The gorgeous and talented Claire Allen joins us for our third recipe. We're making a Wellington.
Yes, so we're making a fish Wellington.
AKA a fancy pie.
Yes, so it's a bit of an upgrade. So I'm going to be making a fish Wellington. So in my pot over here, I've got some sautéed onions.
Okay.
And some garlic. I'm going to add some spinach. You want to do that for
me? Is that spinach? I thought it was basil.
And that's nice and healthy.
So should we add it over
yes,
here?
Yes, you can add that. Okay. And then I'm going to add some cream cheese.
How much of this do you need?
About half of it. That'll be perfect.
Half of it, okay.
Yeah, and then you can just mix it through for me.
Oh, yeah, because it's going to shrink, right?
Exactly, exactly. I'm going to roll out my pastry. Uh-huh. I've used store-bought puff pastry. Life's too short to make your own pastry. It takes way too long. I'm going to roll that out. And then I'm using the grilled hake fillets from Sea Harvest. It's got a nice flavour to it. Get these two out.
Okay.
How's that looking?
It smells amazing. I love spinach.
Exactly. We've got some garlic and some onions. And then we're going to add a little bit of cream cheese.
A little bit or just this whole
About
bowl?
Half. Don't be greedy. And what you're going to do is you just want your spinach to wilter. And then what you're going to do is mix it through. And then we're going to add that to the base, the top of our fish.
Right.
But you need to make sure it cools down. Otherwise, it's going to start cooking your fish and melt your pastry. What we're going to do is I've got a ready done version of here. So you just want to wilter your spinach and you want to saute your onions.
That's how we want it to look.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take half my mixture. I'm going to put that at the bottom.
Mine looks like it's starting to curdle. Is that normal?
No, it's maybe just too hot, and then you can maybe take it off the heat.
Okay.
There we go. And it might be a little bit of the water
we're making TV, because we have one.
There we go. Perfect ones over here. So I'm going to just lay a thin layer at the bottom. You need to make sure when you take your mixture out that you don't have any excess water, because otherwise what's going to happen is you're going to start making your pastry
soggy.
Exactly.
Okay,
there's nothing worse than soggy pastry. What I do over there is I'm going to place that.
Okay, is that from frozen?
Yes, it is frozen.
Okay.
You can do it from frozen. And then what we're going to do is we're going to put this on top.
Right.
I'm going to coat that. And it's basically encasing fish. And what's going to happen is it's going to get nice and warm, it's going to get creamy, and this is going to become like a beautiful creamy sauce with your onions. Now, you could serve this as a beautiful caper and lemon butter sauce if you wanted to, or you could have it just on its own.
Okay.
I like it. Like the traditional beef Wellington served with a gravy,
and
maybe some mashed potatoes, really British.
Yeah.
This could possibly do exactly the same thing. Some mashed potatoes and a beautiful lemon and butter sauce.
Perfect.
So I'm going to do this. I'm going to just cut this down. And I'm going to cover it. So you want to encase your entire pastry because you want your fish to actually steam. Now, when you're doing your beef one, you sear your beef and then you coat it with the
yoursel.
It's the same thing. So you want to make sure it's completely closed up. It's exactly the same process. And then seal that up.
So just pinch it down.
Okay. And then you can make a long one, you can make two small ones. It's nice and fancy if you're doing a dinner party. You can do little individual ones. It's quite fancy and quite smart. And then everybody will have one on the table. But this is really nice. What you can do is you can serve this in a big log on a board and you can slice.
And then you can
slice it.
Yeah.
Like nice harvest table type things.
Yeah.
I'm going to do now, just be careful when you take it off and make sure you flour your board. And then what we're going to do is we're going to move it to our baking tray. Now I've taken a baking tray and I've put some butter on that. It's not going to stick. And then you bake that in the oven on 220 degrees for 30 minutes. You want it to be really, really warm because you want all the butter in the puff pastry to just actually rise, and that's going to make that beautiful crispy pastry.
Yeah, yeah.
And there you have it.
Voila. And then the end product is going to look like that.
Absolutely.
Those look absolutely gorgeous. This is definitely for sure the kitchen that keeps on giving.
Sea Harvest is giving away some mystery prizes, so pop over to our Facebook, Afternoon Express. And obviously, for the recipe and the ingredients, pop over to afternoonexpress.co.za. I think that's ready to be served, right?
Okay, let's go.
Wow.
Hi.
Hello. This table is a sight for sore eyes. You lot are really turning me into a kitchen wonder.
Where do you start?
Looks amazing.
They look amazing. While no one was looking, I stole one of these ginger biscuits.
I could see one
and
was
my goodness. I was heavenly. Absolutely heavenly. Yeah. Thank you so much for joining us today.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Yes. I hope more and more people will get their faces profiled. You guys should do it.
I'm in.
Well, should we profile this food?
Yes. Absolutely.
While we do that, tomorrow on the show, we've got the energetic Dr. Malinga in the loft, and he has promised us one of the most electric performances we've ever had on Afternoon Express, so you don't want to miss out on that. How does that taste? Mm. Glorious,
huh?
Good.
Thank you so much. Join us again next time, same place. Happy eating and good night.
Another feel-good production.